Hello everyone, this is Mr. Appel, and today we're going to learn about piecewise functions. So let's start with an example of an actual real-world piecewise function to kind of help it make it make sense. So a great example of piecewise function is movie ticket prices. So typically movie ticket prices are different for different age groups. A piecewise function is just any function that is really just a combination of different functions. Where it's different depending on different domains or different parts of the function or different pieces of the function, hence the term piecewise function. And so movie tickets is a great example of that. A typical pricing scheme might be what you see here. Under 6 years old is free. Sorry, I'm just trying to grab my pen tool here. So under 6 years old, there it is. Sorry. Under 6 years old is free, but then for ages 6 to 12, it's a different cost. It's $8, and then for a different price when you're over 65, it's a different cost, and then other people, it's a different cost. So for different ages, it's different prices. And so we want to write a function that conveys that, but there's no simple one function because, again, it's different for different ages. So we're going to write a piecewise function. So we're going to define that function like this. We're going to say f of x is equal to, and then we're going to use a giant curly bracket, and then we're going to define it for each domain. So the first piece is for the under 6, and so the value of the function is free, so the cost is 0. So the value of the function is 0, but it's 0 only when the child is under 6, when the person is under 6 years old. So that's when the x values are less than or equal to 0 and less than 6, right? So any x values in that interval there from 0 to 6, including 0 but not including 6, although you could argue a 0-year-old person, someone who's actually 0, isn't going to the movies, but that's a different conversation. So then the next piece is here from ages 6 to 12. It's $8. So the value of this function is 8 when x is between 6 and 12. So 6 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 12. So those ages 6 to 12 include the ages 6 and 12, which is why those are both or equals. Now I'm going to skip ahead to the everyone else because that's really that everyone else. It's implied that's people older than 12 up to age 65. So that's $10 for everyone from age 12 all the way up to age 65. And it's going to be less than or equal to 65. Because it's once you get over 65 is when it jumps down to $6. So if you are 65, you don't get that discount. And then the function is going to be equal to 6 when x is greater than 65. And so that right there is a piecewise function. And again, it's depending on the domain, you get a different value. And so if you wanted to evaluate this piecewise function, so let's just say you wanted to evaluate f of 10, which is really just asking what is the cost for a 10-year-old. You evaluate it by finding the correct interval, finding the correct domain. So 10 is in this domain right here. It's between 6 and 12. And so the output would be the value of the function, which is 8. So in this piecewise function, f of 10 is 8. In other words, a 10-year-old person will pay $8. If I wanted to evaluate this function for 70, so a 70-year-old person, you would look at the domain and see, oh, when x is greater than 65, that's me, I'm 70, my cost is 6. And so f of 70 for this function would be 6, because again, a 70-year-old person would be paying $6. That's all for now. Thanks.